Hello everyone, I am the Plane Shifter facing to the universe of Pyre. Last episode, Jodariel and Pamita decided to get on better... decide to not bicker with each other so much. Mostly on Jodariel's side is the bickering, but let's commence the ride, because they will both be on there together. The afternoon is just beginning to give away to nightfall as you and your companions finish making preparations for the coming rite. Throughout the ceremony, you realize Pamita is nowhere to be found. The last anybody saw of her was shortly after the Black Wagon came to rest here at the Hook of Oz. She returns just as you are beginning to plan a search for her.
Sorry
to have argued you there, neither, darling. Just getting a little antsy is all. Had to go and spread my wings a bit. And shake away the nerves. She's holding something back. Don't you get in my head, I'm telling you the truth. I'm telling you the truth, damn it. Damn you, Rido, get out, get out, get out! Anyhow, it looks as if the show's about to start. I shall be on the field with yours. As Pamita departs, you see she's right as the stars above begin to shine. You know she's about to face her sister, Tamita, once again. You accept that it's a very private matter between them. Ooh, constellations? Something else catches your notice in the sky. This time, strange news starts shimmering about the ones you recognize.
Carithus.
The greater titans have returned.
Sum Corevara.
Some of them are in meddling spirit, not in form. But those dark stars are portentous signs. Though they may light your way, you are the path which they illuminate, right, Reader? Henceforth, you might invite influence of the Titan stars. Omens in the night sky represent one of the downsides mythical monstrosities. Use the Titan stars for a greater challenge. Slaying routed long ago to greater Titans are an indelible part of the legend of the Eight Stripes. Look upon ten without fear.
Behold the Titan stars.
They are black. Go upon this Titan to hunk up faster. Your adversaries shall have plus 8 hope, making them return sooner after banishment. Okay. At the start of the ride, your pyre shall automatically suffer 13 damage. Whoa. Your adversaries shall be more cunning and much quicker to react. Okay, they are faster. Against this, this is bad. Let's try this.
Limbless Erzek.
Yeah, let's try one. Let's not do it too much. If I get crazy, I might turn them all on. Activate it for a greater challenge. Reveal.
The Titan stars. Burning remnants of monstrosities veiled by the scribes themselves. Dare you to stand against them in their fury? Dark is the knowledge that you seek there, reader. Best focus on your adversaries, keen as they are to confront you once again. Put out their pyre first, and show them the glory of the Nightwings. Now then, make ready for the rite!
Indeed. The winged exiles of the Essence take position opposite to your own companions, and their leader soon asserts himself. Pamita, come forth, no trickery this time. She appears as asked, though remains silent as her blood sister studies her for a time. Pamita then reaches for her mask. You look weird to me, sister. Oh, too little sleep, I guess. I do get rather anxious sometimes on the nights before one of those things. It can be a lot of pressure. Understandable. The two of them say nothing for a time. You cannot discern what they are thinking. The right-wing remnants all seem to be very mentally acute, trained as they are from birth. Soon enough, Pamita cuts through the tension, her tone light as ever. So, giving further thought to my proposal then? I have. And I think that's now not the time for talk. Besides your comrades there, surely you give them pause. Even now, they must be questioning your loyalty. What? But I... Oh, cut it with stammering, Pamita. It's very up and coming, you know that. And you'd be sure to tell those comrades of yours that you... what you'd propose it to me. She dons her mask once more. As you rejoin the other exiles of the Essence, Pamita hesitates before returning to your grove. I told her she could take my place. That I would keep her up to date about our progress, and that she could take my place if ever it was time for me to go.
It's not Ocean.
But you don't have to worry. For one thing, she refused, and for another, well, I'd better tell you later. For now, remember, you can count on me. Pamita, I hope so.
Now let us begin.
In the front, Jodariel.
Jodariel.
In the side, Edwin.
Edwin.
Ship summon.
In the back. I think this is a good one for her. Pamita.
Pamita.
You still put your faith in me then, leader darling, even knowing I could slip free of your influence if I ever so chose. Then I shall have to do my part as well. Face you, wastrels of the Commonwealth. The pain and loss of your defeat this night shall reverberate not only in your hollow hearts, but in the homeland that abandoned you. Are you quite sure it has to be this way then, sister? There is no compromise here, Pamita, not for traitors to my country or my blood. I understand, then so be it. Alright, take the front. I need to dive, alright.
Wings up first to strike the adversary's flame. A bit of a blunder.
Oh no. No!
Alas!
It's bad. Drop it! Go, go, go! Yes!
With force of will.
True. That was nice. You seem so distracted, Pamita. Is there something more you wish to say to me? Would you feel that I'm old, perhaps? Pamita stops at this and wishes for her mask. I am sorry for what I did to you, sister. For what you did to me, your apology rings hollow as your plumage. You might rehearse it further upon every last survivor of the Hymen remnants. Now no more talk!
Such hatred spewing constantly from Tamitha, yet here in exile.
Oh no.
All for naught.
Maybe not. Okay, Hedwig, nice.
Not
throw in.
Force of will behind that thrust.
Nope. go, go. There!
Yes.
Yeah, that's going on.
The Nightwings now are closer to achieving victory. Quite the turn of events.
Yes. Just die, just die.
Edwin plunged into their fire.
Where is the orb?
Too slow there, Pabatha.
Go, 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 go.
Shall it
go,
be
go.
The orb is up.
Ah! That was a nope. That was a big nope.
A shameful
no!
outcome. Your flames grow weak.
Drop it. Ah!
Oh, yes!
Didn't quite work. Dive, dive! Oh! Okay. Drop it! No, that's too close.
There it is.
Oh crap. That was a big, big mistake I made. Edwin. Nice.
Ouch.
Just die.
Flames of freedom.
Okay, okay.
No more than a lick of flame remains. There.
There. Whoa. I juke at everybody. Wow.
The Nightwings prevail yet again.
No, sir.
Their adversaries confidently thwarted. Thus end this night's proceedings.
You win, Blood Sister. You win. I don't suppose that means you reconsider. You know that I cannot. You were always obstinate, but in that regard and all others which count for anything, you are inferior to me. Remember that. What you offered is meaningless to me. I shall free myself without your help, or that of Agnion. Now then, farewell. I don't think that's what the rites all teach. I mean, you need help of at least two other people and a reader. Wait, what of your comrades, the Essence? You must need them at least. Missing my words as ever, Pamita. You know that I do love you, in a way. Is that what you wish to hear? But my purpose is plain, and you stand in its way. You are a fool to think my freedom is my goal. My freedom is a means toward an end, the likes of which you never would abide. Do you think that you could sway me from my purposes, Pamita? Destroy the Commonwealth? Pamita remained silent for some time.
Concilia.
No, I think that you struggle to destroy the Commonwealth, no matter what it takes. No matter if, in doing so, you are destroyed instead.
Merove Kranta.
Just so. So then you understand me. Pamita does not turn to watch her blood sister depart.
The rites do tend to teach something of trust.
No matter what anyone says, I refuse to think that there is some sort of limit to one's understanding of all this. So, Hedwig and his allies may instantly return banished the islands by moving to where they fell, okay, and this... Hedwig and his allies caused banished adversaries to remain banished for 2 seconds longer than usual. I think I'll go to this one first.
exiled Pamatha perhaps can learn the errors of her kind.
Well, Tamitha, sooner I'll be catching up with you at this, whether or not you like it. Oh, let's check her masteries. Swift flight. While flying, Pamitha moves faster. That's cool. After saluting adversaries, Pamitha instantly switches places with her nearest ally. Pamitha can use her dash ability in rapid succession and for less stamina. So interesting. Pamitha permanently gains plus 8 quickness, making her move much faster. And here, so what's it? Mastered aggressive capabilities, swiftness and mobilities. Okay. For 5 seconds after banishing an adversary, Pamitha moves 35% faster than usual. While casting her aura, Pamitha can trigger an aura burst that banishes nearby adversaries. If Pamitha is banished while Wing Dead Fury's effect is active, she turns into Frostbus quickly. Wing Dead Fury, okay. Natural Sonya. Pamitha permanently gains plus 4 to quickness, presence, and hope, making her better all around. Oh, interesting. I can make her faster or more aggressive and balanced. Oh, what should I choose? I think I'll go for quickness. What am I doing to Hedwig? Let's go for quickness.
The holy power of the eldest matriarch. Until the next rite.
See you there. The Nest of Trieste is a fiery celestial landmark whose burning fiercer is blah blah blah. Back at the wagon, after prevailing over the essence and rather soundly, you are about to join the others discussing the outcome when Valfred finds you.
Tebra de Braves.
Good work back there, my king. Though I am afraid I must pull you away from any revelry, for there is something you should see. Please join me outside.
Vimestaritas.
Look forth, the Golden Star reveals itself to us once more. Indeed, somewhere deep into the infinite dark, a single star shines brighter than the rest. The path of freedom reveals itself once again. Let us confirm our destination. Next rite shall free someone. Take a look at the planner. 31%. Oh yes, I placed it exactly the one I wanted. A good guy shall be free, should the fate win, but I don't plan on letting them. The Tempests shall not play for a while. Alright. The Golden Star burns brighter over the Fall of Solian. Dalbert is already on his way. Hedwig, you're going free. The rites are calling you again to the Fall of Solian, where one among you may go free, should you prevail.
Barushta.
It's as we discussed, the cycle of rites is beginning to turn more quickly. Perhaps the scribes themselves have taken notice. Fortunately, having more frequent opportunities to free ourselves is not unwelcome to our plan. I suppose it's good for everyone, including the fate who will oppose us next. Valfred ambitious plots to spark the revolution in the Commonwealth as peacefully as possible. Interesting? Interesting. 31%. Getting to Maltalodia ought to be a little easier than before, at least. We should be able to make landing near to some of the old monuments of the scribes. Let's set forth at them. Sure. Soon everyone is off to rest as best as they are able, knowing that another chance at liberty from one of them shall soon present itself. può... Ok. Tamita? Pamita, sorry. Despite Pamita's mental conditioning, you can tell something is troubling her. She won't listen to a word I say. Not one damn word. If she weren't my blood sister, I should think I'd hate her guts as much as she hates mine. She shakes her head. I should apologize to you and everyone. I sought out Tamita without asking her leave. Figured I would rather seek forgiveness than permission, you understand? Who do you think you are? Oh man, I totally forgot the name of the character I was... Oh man, I can't believe I forgot the name of the character I was going to refer to. Whatever. It was a reference to The Legend of Korra. How can I forget the name of the character? Brain, you're fired. My attempts with Tamita didn't amount to much, as you well saw, so at this point, I'm hopeful you'll be more accepting of apologies than she. Asami! Asami Sato! Yes! Man, whatever. How could I forget for so long? Don't tell me something, reader darling. Do you suppose I'm going to betray you? You may know better than I do at this point. Pamita wishes to know where you think her loyalties lie. Loyalty has to be earned. You believe she will stand with the Nightwings? I do not know. Do I think you will betray us? You know, your trust... You act weirdly, but that's for loyalty to your sister. I think you'll be loyal to your sister. But would you betray us for her? I don't think that will accomplish anything. I'll trust you for now. You express to Pamita that you do not view her efforts to make peace with Tamita as being contradictory to the group's larger goals. You understand why she did what she did. She says nothing for a while. That's kind of you to say, darling. Maybe others see it with such generosity, but if they don't, you need but to tell me to depart, and I'll be on my way. However, I've a promise that I wish to make to you. You let me stay, and I'll see this through, with all of you, no matter where we all end up. I'll be on the roof for a bit, I think. You take care, too, darling. Despite Pamita's disappointment with the outcome of her confrontation with her blood sister, I think she's less troubled now, after your brief conversation. Whoa, okay. Sandra is living in the past. Greetings to you, lovely reader. I am at your disposal. Nothing on your mind. You know where to find. What's everybody doing? Wolfred's standing up. Jody's watching her clothes. Edwin is gazing into the abyss. She's nearby, alright. Gilman's is communing with the sea. Ryze is staring at the book. Tizo is staring at the fish. Greentail is splashing around. And Tarek is listening to the sea. Inspiration, perhaps. Better apps to you. Let's read a lot now. The greater titans. The star shines strange beneath the sea. This one that had rise from the water shows that he could see them plain, the burning essence of those who came before. Our lives are but a quest to join the stars, the one longed to be the brightest. This one longed to be the brightest. But in the downside, this one met those whose own stars shall doubtless burn at least as hot. Together we achieved great deeds. You may have seen some evidence of it. The remains of the greater titans, which once darkened this dark land. But in our kingship was the strength to conquer them. This one's humble charge to chronicle those deeds, and may the Titan star never stain the sky during your time. Limbless Arzek. If this one is to be honest, the Inari expected his high-minded friend, Luz Clorian, ever to rise arms, and yet, it was Clorian alone who toppled the Root Titan, which befouled the serenity of Wakingwood. Clorian, he brought to bear the might of his entire family of willful saps contained within his ancient gnarled staff. Soon did the poisoned soil of Limbless Azriak begin to dissipate. The Root Titan cried out a deafening last cry, and we tread to a speck. Azriak yet lives, a husk, a single full seed, yet rotting where all something might stood. Sclodion, in his mercy, deigned that the surrounding woods ought to grow bold and strong by casting off the influence of Azriak, not by forgetting. The Essence. The winged members of the Essence, which chosen by the Matriarch Trieste Tits, are living exemplars of liberty and piety. Would that my wings could be thus. Us, of course, you must know we all had wings. It said the men and women of the Empire relinquished theirs, drowning by earthly matters as they were, but the harps such as Trieste held tight the liberty they plumage would afford. These divergent paths did cause a share of differences between the winged and the wingless over time, but here in this land, our purposes are shared, our goals united. That then is the essence. That is who they are, and what and why. Alright. Believe I read everything. And with that, I shall say thank you guys so much for watching. I am the Planeshifter, and I am phasing out.